In this video, we will process a contig assembly project and save the consensus sequence in the BioNumerics database. I start by adding a new entry to my database to which the assembly project will be linked. And I create a new sequence experiment type for nucleic acid sequences. Double-click on the newly created entry, and in the Entry Edit window, click on the flask next to the newly created sequence type. The software tells me that this experiment is not yet defined for this entry and asks whether I want to create a new one. I confirm. An empty sequence viewer window opens. We can start assembler by clicking on the Open Assembler button. The assembler window consists of two tabs, the Trimming tab and the Assembly tab. We start in the Trimming tab, where we can press the second button to import raw chromatogram files from an automated sequencer. Select the sequences and adjust for the correct file format. Then click Open. The left upper panel lists the names of the chromatogram files, each with their length in base pairs before and after trimming. The upper right panel gives a graphical overview of each partial sequence, showing a color code for the quality of the densitometric curve. Green stands for high quality, ranging over yellow and orange, towards red, which stands for a low quality. The beginning and end of each partial sequence, which usually are of lesser quality, were automatically trimmed off. The trimming sites are marked by black pipes, and the trimmed off regions are underlined by a black bar. The bottom panel shows the raw chromatogram file. Zoom sliders allow you to zoom in on the curve horizontally or vertically. If I click on a sequence in the upper panel, the cursor will automatically jump to the same location in the trace file panel. Trimming ends can be adjusted manually. If I don't want these two black peaks to be trimmed off, I click on the first black peak and on Mark Start of Sequence. The black bar is removed from under the black peaks, meaning that they will be no longer trimmed off. The same goes for adjusting the end of a sequence. Inside a sequence, there also may occur regions of less quality. These are indicated by a yellow or orange color and are underlined by a gray bar. This gray bar defines an inactive zone. Inactive zones will only be included in the assembly if there is no other partial sequence of better quality available for that same region on the gene. These active or inactive regions can as well be edited manually. Select a nucleotide or a range of nucleotides and press the button to activate or inactivate that nucleotide or region. Now we will move to the next step and assemble the sequences. I will do so with the default settings. The resulting assembly is shown in the Assembly tab. The top left panel lists the resulting contigs and indicates the length of the consensus sequence in base pairs and the number of partial sequences included. The top panel graphically outlines the position and orientation of the separate partial sequences in relation to the consensus sequence. The middle panel zooms in up to nucleotide level, and the panel below shows the selected raw trace file. These three panels are synced. The below panel can also be shown in aligned mode by switching to the Aligned Traces tab. In this view, all available trace files for that position are shown. The gray arrows indicate whether the trace was used in forward or reverse direction. The zoom sliders may help to visualize some areas better. Unresolved positions on the consensus are indicated in pink. Clicking on such a position allows you to examine the corresponding chromatogram peaks and make base calling corrections if desired. All modifications made to a partial sequence are listed under the Information button and can be selected and/or discarded from within this dialog. The orange color indicates positions where not all partial sequences result in the same nucleotide, and the consensus nucleotide was chosen according to a majority rule. The order of appearance of the trace files can be changed by clicking on a trace and using the page up, page down keys or the corresponding arrow buttons. Possible primer ends can be trimmed off the consensus sequence. Press the consensus trimming button to enter the target patterns to look for. You have a choice to allow mismatches and specify a target range in which the trimming site should be found. The number stated in the offset boxes indicates the amount of base pairs to be trimmed off the target and thus to be left out of the consensus sequence. I click OK, and the trimming ends are indicated on the graphical overview. All technical information on the settings used to achieve this Contig project can be viewed in the assembly report. The settings used in this project can be saved in a template for later use. Click the Templates button and press Save Current. Here you can type a name for your template. It is now available to be loaded in a future project. When I press the Save button and close the project, the consensus sequence is saved in the underlying sequence viewer window. How to align and compare sequence data is explained further in our other videos.